आइए आइए, आपकी शर्ट फ्रीजर है, आप उसे लेके थे।
Definitely support this bill. There is no doubt that there is a crying need for increasing the number of judges in the Supreme Court. The only problem, of course, the Honorable Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs is not here, where he will find three more Type 8 bungalows to give three additional judges of the Supreme Court, I don't know. Some houses will have to be transferred to the Supreme Court judges pool because there is a grave shortage of housing. So that will be the only practical problem that I see. But that's on a lighter vein. I'm sure they will find adequate accommodation. But the difficulty now is that five judges, the constitution bench, will be hearing the Babri Masjid case on a day-to-day basis. I think it will go with more than 1 lakh pages. It is bound to go right up to the last day of the Honorable the Chief Justice, which is 17 November. I have no doubt that five judges will be locked in hearing this Babri Masjid dispute. Other members have already given the list of all the cases which are pending with before five judges, seven judges, nine judges, and I know for a fact that some tax issues are also due to come before 11 judges. So therefore, and they are absolutely pressing and crying, both tax issues as well as reservation issues, which are before 11, supposed to be before 11 judges. So we don't know when those will be heard. So therefore, this is a crying need. Therefore, I'm glad that the government has come out with this at this time. Two, three very quick points which I think I have labored on before also. I would honestly urge the Law Minister to kindly, seriously consider this. Even yesterday, the Honorable the Chief Justice in Guwahati, on a visit to Guwahati in the High Court, has said that I have repeatedly requested the government that the age of High Court judges should be increased from 62 to 65. Firstly, there is absolutely no reason why High Court judges retire at the age of 62, and when some of them, on the very last day of their tenure of 62, get appointed to the Supreme Court, become fit to then serve till 65. I cannot understand how you are mentally and physically fit to serve till 62 in the High Court, and the moment you come to the Supreme Court, there's a magical elixir which gives you a further 3 years of life. The Honorable the Chief Justice has, of course, mentioned this from the point of view of bringing down dependency of arrears in the High Court. But I have a more fundamental issue, and I have said this before in this House, that the substratum of justice is really the High Courts, the 1,000 odd judges. Of course, there are now almost 40 to 45% vacancies, not entirely due to the government's fault, I have to concede that. But the substratum of justice in this country comes in from the High Courts. That's really the, and therefore it's very important that High Court judges who were fearless, who were brilliant, and who formed the bedrock for the pool that used to come to the Supreme Court should continue to be so. This extra 3 years that the judges get when they come to the Supreme Court has therefore made the race from the High Court to the Supreme Court an extremely unsavory one, a very taxing one for some High Court judges, and has brought about a great deal of arbitrariness. I'm sorry to say this, there is inherently a great deal of opaqueness in the entire collegium system and the system of appointment. There is little doubt about that. So therefore, what has happened therefore is that who comes to the Supreme Court and gets those extra 3 years, and therefore the tag of a Supreme Court judge has become somewhat of a controversial point. And I know for a fact that there are many High Court judges who would very happily and respectably like to be there in the High Court up to the age of 65 if they are there in the collegium in the High Court, they are serving as Chief Justices of very important High Courts, rendering justice there rather than have this mad scramble to come to the Supreme Court. So therefore, I would urge the Honorable Law Minister to kindly consider this. This is a very important issue, and to bring them at par so that this entire scramble for the Supreme Court will come to an end. That's one of the important points that I wanted to make. Second point that I want to make is that the National Judicial Appointment Commission has unfortunately been struck down. I don't know why the constitution that you have in the Lok Sabha still has 124 head of this thing in its books. I was just seeing it today. But it is a unanimous opinion of the Lok Sabha and near unanimous of the Rajya Sabha, except I think one person, Mr. Ram Jethwalani, voted against it. Otherwise, unanimous opinion of almost 749 members of parliament was struck down by the Honorable Supreme Court. This government now, with a fresh mandate, with you know, a fresh numbers in its ranks, much greater public opinion behind them, much greater opinion of all shades of the House behind them, I think the time is ripe for this government to tweak the earlier law a little bit. It could have actually been read down very easily. I think the government perhaps should have conceded a little bit and let that law remain. If it had a slight bit of concession, I know that I didn't appear in the matter, but I was watching the matter very carefully. And a slight bit of concession from the government, I think the judges were willing to read it down, and this law would have been good law. But I think this law is a crying need of the hour. Therefore, the National Judicial Appointment Commission should be brought back by the 17th Lok Sabha once more, and I think passed with the same degree of unanimity which was done earlier. The Honorable Law Minister has said earlier in this House, and I completely agree with him, that when the Honorable President, the Honorable Prime Minister, the entire Cabinet and the Executive, when they apply their mind, it is not necessary that they come up with bad choices. The kind of judges we had in the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, all the way up to the second judges transfer case, when this was the whole thing in 96 was turned around, there have been exceptional judges. There's no question about it. So the executive, when it was appointing judges under the old system, under Article 124, I don't think there was any problem to that extent, one or two aberrations apart. Now, there are many more aberrations, let's face it. There is no question, many more controversial appointments, many more aberrations. So therefore, I think the imprimatur of the parliament through the executive is a must. Therefore, we must try and bring the NJSC back. One last point, clearly what the Honorable Minister said, he's canvassed the opinion of the House as to whether the National Judicial Service, the time has come. I believe, sir, the National Judicial Service time has definitely come. You must again post haste bring that, because there is a crying need in the tiers of the lower judiciary up to the High Court, for people who come up to the High Court and then all the way to the Supreme Court, that marginalized sections of our society, our friends from the scheduled castes, from the scheduled tribes, they must get their due. I don't think they have got their due. I believe today there is only one scheduled caste judge in the Supreme Court. Fortunately, the number of women has gone up substantially. There are three women judges. We are very happy to note that. But as far as the SC/STs are concerned, I think that is a crying need of the hour. So therefore, the Honorable Law Minister is absolutely right in suggesting that this House back him in bringing a National Judicial Service. This has been a crying need of the hour. So this being so, the problem of opaqueness of appointment is a big problem. This is a problem which can only be resolved by a fresh National Judicial Appointment Committee. So I urge the Honorable Law Minister to carry on the good work that he is doing in the matter of judicial reforms and take this House into confidence, and I'm sure the House will back him to the hilt. Thank you very much, Madam Chairperson.